And thoughts, our feelings only happens at this moment. So it is always the truth. If you listen to yourself, you will always know what is the best for you, because what is the best for you is what is the truth for you. So why does it take so much time to create our reality? Because we haven't been living in our truth. If the feeling is always the truth, why we hesitate to express ourselves? Because we believe that it will bring some sort of unpleasantness to this matter, to ruin our relationship. Because we believe feelings can be negative or destructive, but actually that's not true. How you express your truth is what matters. When you express your truth with love, negative or damaging results rarely occur. And when they do, it usually because someone else has chosen to experience your truth in a negative or damaging way. And if that's the case, you can't do anything about it anyway. But people do this all the time because they're so afraid to face possible unpleasantness. But we cannot take responsibility for how well another person accepts our truth. We can only ensure how well it's communicated. Failure to express the negative feelings does not make them go away. It will keep them in negative, and it will harm our body and becomes a burden of the soul. It is so important to get those negativities go out, to release them. Only by letting them go, putting them out there and place them in front of you, and then you can really understand if they are your reality. And only when you put them in front of you, then you can really know if you do believe them. But feelings can be very tricky. Feelings are the language of the soul, but we have to make sure that we're listening to our true feelings, but not something that is constructed in our mind. Most of the time, when we deal with a matter or when we are communicating with someone, we like to immediately go back to our previous experience and use that to make our judgment, because we think that is more efficient and that can protect us. So instead of going in the moment, we stand outside of the moment and judge it. What will happen when we do so? Number one, we can have the wrong judgment, because things are changing, people are changing. So we can come up with a judgment that things are not the way that we decide how we feel about this matter this time. And number two, because we are having a different thoughts about this matter or this person using our previous experience. So we are sending energies to this matter, to this person, and that can influence how this matter or this person is going to feel about us. So in a way, we are changing the matter to a different direction because of us, because we can create realities all the time. And if this is what we do to people, to matters, we are going to do the same thing to ourselves. And that will prevent us from growing, because we will not believe that we have unlimited potential. So instead of using our filtered emotion to judge people or matter, if we can just live in the moment, and that can change our view of how we look at the world and everything else and ourselves, then we can change our life. Cannot wait to see you next time.